order for these girls to stay in school, they need these basic, simple things so that they can continue going. It's already so hard for them. And they work so hard. They've been so hard. And it's important that their stories are told because they live in rural areas where they don't have internet, they don't have a way to share their stories. And this is why I started Her Story Talks, so that we women who can share these stories and help them out can do this. And it leads me to these women here working with me to make this happen for these girls' life. So now I will introduce each one of them to speak about their story and why we are all here and how important sisterhood is, women empowerment, and how important it is to include men. So thank you for being here, and so that we can all balance each other. There's a couple of panelists. Yar, Elizabeth, are you here? She is late. Minika, she is the founder of KOllision. She is supposed to be here, but I believe she's running around upstairs because we have to get the fashion show together for everyone once we finish this talk. So we'll start with the ladies that are here. Let me get my questions out. I am not texting. Founder of Theory of Gaia, which is an amazing, amazing store that has beautiful clothing. And she's a mother, she's an activist, she's a woman, feminist warrior. And she will tell you a little bit more of herself. And next, we have Karen. Karen is an award-winning filmmaker and actress. She is the star of critically acclaimed series, Doomsday, and so many more things that she will tell you about. She's also an activist and a change maker. And we have my lovely dear friend, Diandra Forrest. And she's a mother, she's an activist, she's the first albino supermodel, and she advocates for albinism and providing children with albinism education and giving awareness about what albinism is. So, let's start with you, Diandra. Tell us your story.
Hello, everyone. So, as Mari introduced me, my name is Diandra Forrest, and I have albinism, which is a genetic condition that causes lack of pigmentation in the hair, skin, and eyes. And I think the stats are maybe like 1 in every 20,000 people have albinism. Something that's passed down genetically. So I have a younger brother who has albinism, but my older brother is very dark skinned, and there's just a range of diverse skin colors in my family. So of course, growing up, you know, being the odd one out, having this very fair skin, growing up in the hood, I'm from the Bronx, it was a bit challenging. So, but I always knew that I wanted to model, and now I'm a model, and I just use my platform to raise awareness about what albinism is, just the day-to-day life of someone with albinism. I guess some of the main challenges in the U.S. is, you know, since we have such fair skin, we need to protect our skin all the time with sunscreen and wearing protective gear, maybe hats and sunglasses. Some cases are more severe than others, but in other countries, in a lot of countries in Africa, they don't have access to these supplies, and there are even superstitions that people with albinism have magical powers or can cure things, so they are actually attacked or even sometimes killed for their body parts. So it's a very sad situation, and I work with a couple of foundations and organizations who are trying to stop this, to educate people on the science behind albinism, and just really explain to people that, you know, we're all human, we all have the right to life, you know, the right to just be who you are and not be attacked because of it. And here in the U.S., I wanted to use my platform. I started a campaign called the Beyond My Skin campaign, and it highlighted five people who have albinism, and for them really just to have a safe space to share their story and just really get the message out that people need to be more tolerant of differences and to
north of Sweden. I'm an actress and a filmmaker, like you said, but yeah, I was born in the north of Sweden. My family's heritage is Sami. It's the indigenous people of Sweden. So my grandfather went to school in a little sleigh behind a reindeer. Mm-hmm. And I'm not making that up. Wow. I came to America 10 years ago, I think. Before that, I lived in Paris. I came here to study art and theater and to model. I've always used modeling as a vehicle to be able to educate myself and create art and be a part of that world. And even though sometimes during some periods of my life, I was almost ashamed of being a model. It wasn't like deep enough. But I've come to realize that having that privilege to be able to travel and study and reach places and people that I would never otherwise have reached. So I'm very grateful for my modeling experience because it has allowed me to eventually start to create what I'm doing now, which is theater and film and TV. I was a producer for the Doomsday TV series, which is currently on Amazon. I was also the star on that show. And since that took off, I created more and more TV series I'm trying to pitch them, and I'm trying to sell them. It's not easy. We're getting some good response. My latest show was a finalist for the Sundance Lab this year, so we're still going to reach.
Let us know if you need an actress.
I do.
And
have you said something so important about
mass
moving, being a ashamed, calling yourself a model, because it was a
deep.
I thought the same thing. Just also being human and not having a purpose that felt like I was doing things. So that was so important for me, and that's what helped me realize that I need to use my platform versus letting my platform use me. What do I want to tell the world and why?
Exactly. Yeah. So that feels really good to eventually in life find that place, even if you don't find it immediately, but where you're like, okay, so I have now this platform. And then I have these stories that I want to tell. And this is what I, Karen, want to see on TV or read or see on a theater stage. So you know what? I'm not going to wait around for other people to create that or for me to go to audition to play this or that role that other people created. No, I'm going to create it. And when I came to that realization, that was a life changer. So now I'm doing that.
I feel like we are co-creators.
Oh, reality. Yes, so very much.
If you have something you want to change, why don't you take action?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. I love it.
What's your story, Ms. Hamacha?
Hello. What is my story? I'm Hamacha, the founder of Theory of Gaia. And like Mari said, it's a store located in the Lower East Side. And what you just said, I think, is so powerful because we're both African, I'm from Zambia. And in my culture, I'll speak particularly from a Zambian perspective. It's like you're raised to be like a lawyer or a doctor or these things. It's very much part of African culture, and I'm sure even Indian culture, a lot of cultures. And for me, even when I was young, it's like,
but I love art, I love interior design, I love fashion.
And my family just looked at me like, why would you do something so retarded? Because they just don't get it, They don't have the respect for the arts that living here has. Like, they don't understand that you could be an interior designer, you could be an artist, you could be in fashion, and you can actually sustain yourself. And it's all about, as far as women's empowerment, it's about sustaining yourself, isn't it, at the end of the day? So I went through this kind of like, okay, I'll go to business school, then I had a corporate job in other amazing fashion companies where I learned so much.
And then I just decided, you know what, I'm going to do this for myself. I'm going to create a company that brings really cool fashion forward, you know, affordable price points. And I want to be the example for so many Zambian girls that we can do other things. We cannot, you know, we can do fashion, we can do art. We can sustain ourselves, you just have to have the passion for it. And it all starts with an education. You know, I'm the prime example of what an education can do. You know, my mother, who was in an abusive relationship with my dad, you know, she was like all about education. She was all about, I'm gonna go out there and do what I have to, and gave us, I'm so fortunate. Now that I have this opportunity to have a business, and you know, and still grow, what can I do? I don't want to be, you know, be here comfortable in the Western world and just be like, oh, I'm Zambian and okay, this is what I do. No, it's about giving back. So what I do with my company is support amazing girls. We actually do work with a fashion school, high school, yeah. We have interns that I work with from there. Yeah, she came into the store the other day and we had Rashida. So what I'm about and what my company is about is just about empowering women and bringing, you know, conversations like this together and just saying that, you know, we all have, we can all support so many causes and we are the lucky ones, you know, the fact that we're here and we get to live our lives as what we choose to be. So yeah, that's what I'm about.
Love it. And since we are talking about how important ourselves with what we believe. As women, I want to ask all of you, what do you feel about sisterhood? And how do you come together with other women to empower them? And if you have and tried, have you had any challenges? Who wants to start with this?
I'll start with that one because that's what my business is about. So, what's the question? There's so many parts.
Like three parts.
So you say sisterhood.
One another, and if there were any challenges.
Okay. Well, again, my mother. I come from a family of so many strong women. It's intense being in a room with all of us because we're all so strong and have such strong personalities, and it's like everything is like a debate. The color of something silly. It's like, no, you know? But I mean, I was raised by an extremely strong feminist woman who taught me to just, from a little girl, she used to say to me, you're special, you know, you are, you know, don't follow what everyone else does. I mean, every single day, my mother instilled that in me. And I think that's really what's helped me in all the challenges that I go through life. And for me as a businesswoman, as an entrepreneur, it's something that I do influence, and I, you know, I work with women, I dress women, and it's actually quite funny. It's like I've realized being in the store, when I'm in the store, how so many women, we all have all these goals, all these things we want to do, and we have so much self-doubt, you know, self-doubt, like I did too. But then if we surround ourselves by strong, amazing women, we can truly do it. Like, there's nothing we cannot accomplish. Like, I remember when I decided I wanted to do fashion, my family was like, why would you do that? I remember when I decided I wanted to open up my own business, so many friends, why would you do that? And so many things, but I had that